Hi everyone, Jill MacKay here in my studio in Bellevue, Colorado. How are you? It's a beautiful summer day and I hope your week is going well. Mine's going pretty smoothly, feeling pretty blessed. Having an issue with Facebook today, so I'm just going to record this and post it on Facebook and YouTube a little later. So let me show you what we're going to make today, okay? I have been dreaming about the stars because a good friend of mine and I are going up to one of the most darkest areas in the country just to look at the stars. We're going to camp out, and apparently this particular spot is phenomenal, absolutely phenomenal, that the stars and the Milky Way and hopefully maybe even some meteor showers will occur. It's pretty amazing viewing up on top of the world. We'll be up actually a little bit past the continental divide. So you'll understand now why I designed this. Let me switch over to my hands here. It's a midnight sky star bracelet. And you can see that it's made out of foiled leather and leather cord, check glass beads, and some rose gold bicones, crystal bicones. It's super easy to make. First thing we're going to do is start with the bead embroidery, but I just want you to see how beautiful and shimmery this rose gold is. It's just beautiful. Here's what it looks like in a bigger piece. It's rather sparkly, but so are stars. So we're going to have to take two of those pieces and we're going to start the bead embroidery on only one, and then the other one will be glued onto the backside to cover all the bead embroidery. Let's take a look at the materials a little closer. So I have these two die cut shapes, which I cut using my dies, my jewelry making dies from Sizzix, and they're on the deep royal with rose gold foil. And I have some rose gold 3mm Swarovski crystals. Here are some true vitriol etched 2mm fire polish. And I have some cobalt blue 2mm fire polish. I haven't decided yet which I'm going to use. It'll probably be the cobalt blue. So these are tiny little 2mm fire polish. I'll be using 1G thread. About two arms length. I'm going to stretch it out and then I'm going to thread my needle so we can begin the bead embroidery. For good measure, I'm just going to run it through the beeswax to condition my thread. And then I'm going to run my fingers over it just to get rid of any excess and rub the rest right into that thread. I'll be using tulip beading needles, size 10 long. I'm not sponsored by them. They're just my favorite beading needles. Also, we're going to be using the rotary hole punch tool. This one's from Beadsmith. And if you haven't seen one, they're pretty slick because this little dial rotates and lets you control the size of the hole. And for today, I'm going to be using the smallest setting, and this tool is actually made for punching and leather stitching. Okay, so let's thread our needle, or should I say needle our thread, because this is how I do it. You get the thread till it's right to the very tip of it is between your forefinger and thumb, and then you just press the needle right on. It's so much easier than trying to hold up the eye of the needle and punching at it with the thread. All right, so I'm going to start by making a couple of holes here. The first thing we're going to do is add one of the 6mm check glass beads, and these are an iris, peacock iris, with a light blue finish, 6mm. They're just gorgeous. I think I forgot to mention those. So we're going to be putting one of those right in the center of the flower. Excuse me, the star. So I've made these holes. The other one needed a little bit of adjusting there. I came up from the back with my needle and I picked up one of the 6 millimeters, and then I went down into the second hole, just like that. We're gonna reinforce this 4 times. Though it's kind of hard to see, I probably should have tried to pick one of these with more color on it so it's easier to see. But here I'm gonna just go back up that first hole, pull my needle through, tighten that bead down to the surface, stitch through it, and then go back down the second hole. I'm going to do this a couple more times because this bead sits very high. It's got a very high profile, and when it's being worn, it'll likely get knocked around a bit. So we want to make sure that it's really on there. See how high it sits? So I think this is my 4th time through. Bring it up from the back, go through the bead, and then down through that second hole to the back side of the star. Now, I'm going to tie off here. And to do that, I'm going to take a little stitch in the back of this leather, okay? But it's not going all the way through the leather. I'm just catching the surface of it. And then I pull slowly, make a loop, and then go through the loop, and that ties a little overhand knot, okay? I'm going to stitch over to where the tail end is coming out of the back side. Okay. And then I'm going to tie the two together, overhand knot. And then the next one will be a surgeon's knot, which is through once and through a second time. Pull that down slowly. And I'm going to remove the tail end only, not the working thread, because we're going to begin some more bead embroidery. The next step we're going to do is you're going to come up through that same hole that you punched to place that 6 millimeter bead on. And then you're ready, because we're going to make a round all the way around that 6 millimeter bead with these 3 millimeter bicones, okay? So I'm going to get that bicone down to the leather, figure out where I want that hole to be. I'm going to eyeball it, and then I'm going to pick up my punch and make a little hole right there. Make life easier for putting my needle through. So I'm just going to backstitch now. So I'm going to come up that same hole, the first hole. I'm going to go through the bicone, and then I'm going to pick up 2 more of the bicones. So we're doing a simple back stitch here. Okay, I always like to put the first one on alone, but now I'm picking up 2 at a time. I get those beads down to the leather and I lay them right where I want them to be, make sure they're touching one another. Figure out where I need my hole, and then make another hole for my needle. This just keeps it so simple to stitch through and saves you on needles. Okay, so now I'm going to come up between the first and the second bicone in the hole that's already there. And then I'm simply going to go through both of the bicones that we just added. Okay. Just like that. Then I'm going to pick up 2 more of the bicones and follow that same method of backstitching. We're going to make these beads go all the way around the 6 millimeter. So here I'm scooching them into place and then figuring out right where I need my hole, then using my hole punch on the smallest setting to make a small hole. It's very simple to do. I'm a beginner beading embroidery person, so if I can do it, so can you. All right, this time I'm going to come up between the third and the fourth bead, and then I'm going to go through these two bicones that we just put on. I'm sure you can guess what we're going to do next. We're going to pick up two more bicones. I just want to show you how this goes. See how much sparkle it adds? It's really a lovely touch because it matches the foil on the front of the leather so well. Once again, move them down to the surface of the leather, get them laying exactly right, figure out where I want my hole punch to be, and then make in the hole, just like this. Takes a little more time to punch the hole, but it's so much easier to stitch with these holes in place. It saves on your hands too. My hands are becoming arthritic, so to not have to force that needle up through that leather is a real plus in my book. Okay, I'm stitching back through the last two beads that I added, and I'm going to pick up two more. We're almost all the way around. Again, these are rose gold 3 millimeter. It might be just right to finish this off. So I'm going to go through the first hole that we added in this whole process. Okay, well, I think maybe we can get one more in there. So let's do our back stitching here. I'm coming up right in front of the two beads that I just added, and of course we're just going to move through the two bicones, and we'll pick up one more, and our ring of Swarovski crystals around the 6 millimeter will be done. Okay, giving it a little tug, picking up one last crystal, getting it down to the surface of the leather, getting in place, and we don't have to make a hole because there's already a hole there waiting for us. So we'll go through. Having trouble finding this hole. There we go. Okay. So we got that on. Now we're going to come up two beads before that, and we're going to stitch through the last two. And our ring will be complete. There, all the beads are on. So now, I want to show you what we're going to do next. First, we're going to proceed through two more of the bicones, so we can get over to the point, the center of this particular point. I'm taking the needle down just to anchor all the beads that we just put around the 6 millimeter. And here, let me show you the finished project. You see, we're going to make straight lines, rays, coming out on each of the star's points. So now we're going to go back up. I'm actually just pushed it through the leather. I didn't go through the same hole. And I'm going to pick up one of the cobalt blue 2 millimeter. I'm figuring out where the hole is. And then I'm using my punch. Sorry, my hands are off camera here. But I'm just making a little punch there. I made a punch in the center of that point and then one at the tip. So three holes I just punched. Okay. So I'm going down into the second hole. And then I'm going to come back up into the first hole so I can go back through that first 2 millimeter fire polish. Now I'm going to pick up two more to finish this ray. So each ray is going to have three beads. Get them down to the surface, and then I'm just going to go through the tip here where I've already made that hole. And this time I'm going to come up in the second hole between the first and second beads so that I can then go through the two fire polish that I just added. Okay, so I'm just going to come up from the back through the hole, pull my thread through, and go through those two millimeter fire polish. Just like that. Okay? Then I'm going to go back down through that hole to the back side of the star. And I'm going to stitch like we did before to tie. I want to secure those beads right there. So I'm picking up just the surface of the back side of the leather. Slowly pull a loop, put my needle through, and tie one little overhand knot, just like that. And that will keep those beads in place. Next, I'm actually just stitching over to the next point because we're going to do exactly the same thing. So I'll show you one more time here so you can get the hang of it. I'm going to use my hole punch. I'm going to punch one by the ring of bicones, and then I'm going to put my needle, come up through that, it's like that. Oops, you know what I had done? I punched right through the leather and then right through my working thread. So I'm going to tie a knot here and start again. So what have we learned? We have learned to not have our thread in the path of our hole punch. Okay, so we have one hole punched. So I think it's a good idea, had I just done all the holes at one time. Okay, so I'm picking up one, and then I'm going to pull my thread out of the way and punch that second hole in the middle of the point, and then one right at the tip of the point. Okay, so going down the center hole. Then I'm going to come back up the first hole so we can go through that 2 millimeter fire polish again. It's like that. Then I'm going to pick up two more to finish the ray on this point. Going down through the hole in the tip of the point. Get my tail out of the way there. And then come up in the center hole and go back through those two millimeters that we just added, just like this. Okay, then we're going to go through that hole in the tip to the back side and we're going to do a little stitch in the back, just like we have. Just anchor those down. So we're just going to catch just a little bit of the surface here to tie our little knot that doesn't go all the way through. And all the stitching will be covered up because we're going to glue the second star shape on the back of this. So doesn't matter how messy the back of your star looks with all this stitching, don't worry about it because we're gonna cover it up anyways. Okay, so I pulled a small loop and I'm tying off here. All right,
And then I'm going to stitch over to the next point. And this time, before I stitch over, I'm getting smarter here. I'm going to punch all three of those holes, one by the bicones, one in the middle of the point, and one at the tip of the point. And that way, I didn't cut my thread off this time, right? So. And then I'm going to come up that back hole. After I make my way over to that hole. I think I've got a little bit of a knot here. I'm just going to pull it out carefully. And then I'm going to go up through that back hole here and start this process again, picking up one of the 2 millimeter fire polish. And I am going to continue on this way until I finish all the rays on each one of the star's points. So I'm going to speed up through this very quickly here. Okay, so all the rays are complete on each one of the points, and then I brought my needle to the front side on the tip of this point, and on each of these points we're going to go ahead and add a bicone just for good measure, because we can and we want added bling factor. So I picked up one of the rose gold 3 millimeter bicones and then one of the tiny 15 O's. I'm going to slide that down to the tip. And then we're going to skip the 15 O. We're not going to go through that or it just fall off. We're going to go back down through this bicone. I'm going to move it around a little bit so it sits the way I want it to sit. Then I'm going to go from the back side through that same hole on the tip and just pull it through and snug that bicone right on the tip, just like that. Okay, now I'm going to go through these beads again because we need to make sure this is reinforced very well, because it's going to be worn and the points will be sticking out and will be knocking into things. So we really just want to make sure these tiny little added bling factors are really staying on there. Okay, so I went back down through. I'm on the back side of the leather. I'm going to go through that hole at the tip, just like that, and I'm going to pull it through. I'm going to go through one more time. Okay, maybe two more, we'll see. Up through the bicone. I'm going to go through the 15-0. If I can, okay, got it through. I'm holding on to that bicone with my thumb and forefinger as I pull that thread through. That just keeps it in place and doesn't let you tug on it. And I'm going back down through that bicone, and I came from the back of the leather to the front, just like that. And that's what we're gonna do on each one of the points, okay? So now I'm going to go through the same hole here, and I'm going to just surface stitch over to the next point. Just like when you're tying knots, you don't want to go through it, but you're picking up enough material to keep the thread in place, okay? So we'll go through one more here. We'll take you through one more of these, and then we'll speed right through until they're all done. So I'm back. I'm at the new tip that I want to work on. So I'm going to go through that hole on the tip. It's the same hole that we used when we were putting the the rays on with those 2 millimeter cobalt fire polish. I'm going to pick up one of the bicones and then one 15 millimeter pull those down to the tip. Then I'm not going to go through the 15-0. Get that out of the way a little bit, but I'm going to go back down through the bicone. Then I'm going to take my needle from the back to the front. And as I pull, the extra thread will snug right up, okay? So now I'm going to go back through the bicone just to reinforce it. Oops. Then I'm going to pass through the 15-0 and then I'm going to go back down the bicone. If I can here. There we go. Finally. And then I'm going to tie off here. And you know how we do that? We take a little stitch. We're not going through the leather, just the surface. We pull slowly until we get a loop. We're going to put our needle through the loop. And I want you to do all 5 of your points in exactly the same manner. And then I'll meet you back here to do the next step of the bracelet. So our star is complete. And now we're going to work on the bracelet part, and we're going to use this beautiful blue, deep blue, 1.5 millimeter round leather cord. So I want to get my ends together and find the center, because that's eventually where the star will be placed. Marking it with my left thumb. I'm going to use my little tiny straw here, and I'm going to tie a barrel knot. 1, 2, 3. When I round 4 times, I'm holding those loops in place while I take the end of the leather cord and pass it through the straw. I'm going to slowly pull that through, and then I'm going to remove the straw, holding onto my loops, and I'm just going to work those loops down. You want to keep them straight and in order if you can. Sometimes they get a little goofy on you. Okay, and there's your first knot. Now we're going to pick up one of the 6 millimeter dark blue fire polish beads. I'm going to string it on, bring it down, and again we're going to pick up our straw and we're going to tie the next barrel knots. So between each of the beads, and we're going to put on 6 beads, you're going to wrap around the straw, hold on to the loops while you put the end of the leather through the straw. Okay, pull it slowly through and then remove the straw. Now you're going to scooch that, all those rows up to that last bead, because you want it right next to the bead, okay? Just like that. We're going to pick up another bead and follow the same process until we have done 6 beads. So I believe that I'm going to finish this one more knot. And then I'll go into fast motion here so we can get through the knotting. Pull out the straw. Move those down to the side of the bead and work them a little bit until you get it right where you want it, and then give it a tug. Okay, so you need four more to make six. So you go ahead and do that, and then I'll meet you back here. All right, so we have our six beads. And you want to leave it, set your star down on top of it and leave just enough space there. Obviously, I've switched my beading around, so the beads we just put on are now on my left, but we're following the same exact thing to do six more beads. But you got to leave that, you know, it's about an inch of space, but basically you just lay your star down and mark it with your thumb. Okay, and then tie your first barrel knot. Sometimes you gotta roll them between your fingers to get them the way you want, okay? This one's a little bit wonky, but I'm gonna proceed. All right, so I'm gonna do the same thing, and I'll add on six beads, and I'll be back. Okay, we got all of the beads knotted on. The only thing we have left to finish the base of the bracelet is to add a knot. We're going to add a sliding knot, but this knot is called a scaffold knot. So I have the two strands here, and I cross the left strand over the right, and I'm holding them where they cross. Then I am going to reach through and pull the strand through while leaving a little bit of a loop. And I added that to the things that I'm holding on to. Then I'm going to go over that loop, down and through the bracelet, and do that a second time. This is similar to a barrel knot. But we've gone around twice, and now we're going to go through the two loops that we just wrapped. Okay. We're going to slowly pull them apart and make our knot. Tighten it down, just like that. Give it a good tug, and voila! You have a sliding knot. On this one, the knot is stationary, and the rest of the bracelet. So you'll want to go now and pull that open till you can get your hand in, and then do what I'm doing here and leave about, a little bit like a half an inch or so. Tie a single overhand knot, string on one of the 6mm fire polish, and then tie another overhand knot. This is just for added beauty. It's just simple. Okay. I like to leave a little bit of the end sticking out. That way it won't pull out easily. We're going to do the same on the second strand, tying an overhand knot, keeping it right where we want it there so it's equal distance. Pull that knot down, and then add a 6mm fire polish, and simply tie a second overhand knot and trim, leaving just a little bit of a tail. And that's all there is to the base of the bracelet. All we have to do now is to glue our star on. So I've placed a piece of paper down, so because we're going to be gluing, and we're using Fibing's Leathercraft cement. It says cement, but it's actually a white glue that is specifically made to use with leather. And we're going to use a glue tray and a flat brush that's about a quarter of an inch wide. We want to put both of the star shapes with the back facing up, because that's where we're going to put the glue. You just want to make sure that you cover the entire surface with glue. I'm not being really careful here, as you can see, but I do hold on and make sure the glue goes all the way out to the tip. Okay, and then set that one aside. And now we're going to spread glue all over the back of our bead embroidered star, and we're coating all of those threads, which will really ensure that they never pull out, so you won't lose any beads. So just go ahead and get all of those points covered. It's super simple. Then you're going to want to put your brush in the water, because you don't want that to dry up with the glue on it. Then take the plain star and place your bracelet through the center of the star. Here, let me rearrange so you can see better. Just like that. Okay, with the glue side up, and you're going to turn over your embroidered star and match the points up, and then start pressing on each and every point. When I pick up the bracelet, I turned just slightly so my star was not facing sideways. So I wanted it to be facing flat up, so when you put it on your wrist, it will lay flat. And here you can see that I'm taking some paper crafting clamps or clips, and I'm just placing them in fairly strategic spots over where the where it's going over the leather, because I want that to really dry securely. And then I'm just going to let that sit for about 15 minutes and come back, take off my clips, and guess what? This bracelet's done, and it's really pretty. Super simple to make. I hope you've enjoyed this project. If so, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can visit my website at jillmckay.com, or visit me on Facebook at facebook.com/jillmckay.pro. And I have 2 live Facebook shows a week, and that would be on Wednesday at 2 o'clock Mountain Time and on Sunday at 1 o'clock Mountain Time. Thanks so much for watching.